Okay, here we're taking a look at reactor number 6. So we're going to find 1, 10, and 100,000 more or less in a given number. So for number 1, we're going to label the place value chart, as you can see that I've already done. We're going to use place value bits to find the sum or difference, and we're going to write the answer in standard form on the line. So for example, here we have 10,000 more than 605,472. We have to put those numbers in. So if I have 72, that means I have 7 tens to 1. We have 400. We have 605,000. So that means I have 5,000 and I have 600,000. Okay, so it looks like that. 605,472. Now I want to know 10,000 more than that. I'm going to come over to my 10,000th place. I'm going to put in one number there. Okay. So now we can read our new number. So we have 600,000, 1 10,000, 5,000, 400, 7 tens, 2 ones. Okay. So then looks like that. 615,472. Moving on to the next one, you can see that we have expanded form there. Okay, so again, start with the number that we know. So we have 400,000, we have 8 10,000, 1,000, we have 3 tens, and then we have our 6 ones. Okay, now I want to know 100,000 less than that. I'm going to come over to my 100,000th place, and I'm going to cross one off. Okay. Now, put our answer in standard form, we see that we have 300,000, 8 10,000, we have 1,000, 0 hundred, 3 tens, 6 ones. So we end up with 381,036. So now we take a look at our next one. We're given the first number and the ending number, and we need to find out what did we do to get to that final number. So let's first set up our first number here. So we have 200,000, 310,000, and then 710. Okay. So we need to get from this number to 130,070. So we can see the only place that changes is going to be our 100,000th place, and we're going from 200,000 to 100,000, which means we're crossing one off. So this number here is 100,000 more than 130,070. This one's larger, and it's larger by 100,000 because that's what we crossed off right here. Again, we have our original number, and this is a little bit tricky because we're crossing one off, but we're crossing that off because we need to get to this final number here. Okay. So, moving on to number 2 here. Lucy plays an online math game. She scored 100,000 more points on level 2 than on level 3. But she scored more on 2 than 3. If she scored 349,867 points on level 2, what would she score on level 3? Okay, and then we're going to model that out. So we're going to set up our tape diagrams here, level 2 and level 3. Okay. So I know that level 2, 349,867. Now, going up to this first part, we know that this is more than level 3. So I'm going to draw level 3 a little bit smaller. And we know how much more. So 100,000 is going to go right here. So, now to find out level 3, we're going to do 349,867 minus 100,000. We have her score. Level 3 was 249,867. 57. Moving on to our next page here. Now we're just going to fill in the blanks for each equation. And we have to be a little bit careful here because these are going to look different each time. So, first one here, we need to add 10,000 to this 40,060. So that means our 4 then becomes 5,10,000. And then our letter B, we're taking away 110,000. So we end up with 11,195. Okay, letter C is a little bit tricky because we're adding 1,000. Okay? Which means this 9 right here has to go up, and then the 9 in the 10,000 place goes up, and then the 9 in the 100,000 goes up. So because we're adding 1,000 to 999,000, we now have 1,000,000. So 1,000,000. Moving on to this next one, we're taking away, we're subtracting 100,000. So this 1 in the 100,000 place becomes a 0. And we're left with 29,231. Okay, now these last two are tricky because we're given the answer and the equal sign. We need to find out what we needed to add to this number. So you can see the difference between these two numbers is that 100,000. So we added 100,000. Okay. Moving on to our next one here, we have 38,000 equals 39,018 minus some number. You can see the difference between these two numbers is in that thousands place. Okay, so we subtracted 1,000. Okay, moving on to number 4. You can see I've already filled in our place value chart, so you might want to pause and fill that in for each one. So what we're going to do here with number 4, we're going to fill in the empty boxes. So you can see here, as we look at the numbers that we know, the number that's changing is in the 10,000 place. So you can see that these numbers are going up, which means we are adding 10,000 to each number. Okay. And so this last one, 190,010, becomes 200,010. And 19,10,000 becomes 20,000. Okay. To model that out, we have 100,000. We're going to do our 9 10,000, and then our 1 10. Okay. So what we did is we're increasing by 10,000, which means we added a 10,000. This gets bundled up with another 100,000. So the numbers increase by 10,000. Okay. So moving on to our next one here with level B, again, this time we see that our numbers are going down, so they're decreasing. And you can see the place that's changing is that 100,000 place. Okay. So to fill in this first number, I need to add. So this is going to be 998,756. And I'm going down as I go left to right. So just fill in the rest of them. And I'm going to put 498,756. So this time, the numbers decrease by 100,000. So we can model that out with our first number here. So we have 900,000, 910,000, 8,000, 700, 510, and 61. Okay, so each time we decrease, we're just crossing off 100,000. Okay. Alright, so moving on to letter C here, as we look, we can see the number that's changing is in the thousands place, and the numbers are going down this way. So the missing number here would be 742,369, then 741,369, and keep subtracting 1,000. Now what's tricky here is we're going from 740,000, we're subtracting away 1,000. So instead of having 740,000, we now have 739,000. And so the numbers decrease by 1,000. Okay? And we can model that here with our first one. 700,000, 410,000, 400,000. 10s, and then 9. So we're decreasing by 1,000, we're just crossing off 1,000 each time. Okay? So, moving on to our final one here. If we scroll all the way over here to the right side, we can see that our numbers are going down. Okay? So if we compare this, so the numbers decrease. And we can see that with our final two numbers here. So we can see that the place that's changing is in the 10,000th place. So it's decreasing by 10,000. Now, what's tricky here with this one is to fill in these missing blanks, we actually have to add. Okay, so we have to act go in reverse, so the inverse operation here. So we're actually going to be adding 10,000 because we're going in the backwards direction. So this number would be 98,910. Now we're going to add 10,000 to that. So now that 9 10,000 becomes 10 10,000. And it would look like that. We have to bump over to that 100,000. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tricky, because now we need to show the numbers decreasing. So let's take this first number that we filled in and model how we decreased it by 10,000. So now, to decrease this number by 10,000, we're crossing off 1 10,000 to model how we got to this number. It's a little bit tricky because we had to go in reverse.